Hi, my name is Carl and this is my channel Gadgets and Tech. Today I will show you how to record internal audio on your Mac using Blackhole. If you like this video and find it helpful, please give it a thumbs up. That makes all the difference for me. So, what is Blackhole? Blackhole is a virtual audio driver that lets you record sounds from your computer system or other programs and software. Why do you need Blackhole? The reason that I'm using Blackhole is that I used to use soundflower, which is a similar solution. But when I installed Catalina on my Mac, it turned out that Catalina didn't support soundflower. Blackhole is a new virtual audio driver, 64-bit, that works in Catalina too. How to use Blackhole? I will show you how you can download and install Blackhole from GitHub. It's totally free. I will also show you how you can create aggregated devices and multi-source outputs. First of all, click on the link in the description and go to GitHub. If you just want to install the drivers, download the package, not the source code. Open the package, and if the developer is unidentified on your computer, you must control click it to do this. Otherwise, you won't get the permission to install the drivers. Then just click your way through the installing process. Then you want to go to your Midi settings, and here you can see all your audio devices. On this computer, I don't have Catalina, but Mojave, so I actually have Soundflower installed here as well, but I guess I will uninstall it later. Next thing you want to do is to create a multi-output device. This enables you to output sound to many audio devices at the same time. I am here merging or combining the Blackhole with the built-in audio, but you can also merge it with any other device like your headphones or things like that. You can also give your multi-device a name. After that, you want to create an aggregate device, which is kind of the same thing as a multi-output device. But the difference here is that you can select many input devices for your aggregate device. Then just go ahead and give your aggregate device a catchy name. After that, head over to the sound preferences, and here you can select your newly created devices as input source and output source. And you're pretty much good to go.
If you have any questions regarding this tutorial, please let me know in the comments. And don't forget to subscribe.